active in our weekly interviews with NFL alumni and Florida Sports Hall of Fame inductees, as well as collegiate, high school, youth coaches and players, conversations from the clubhouse, as well as entertaining guests weekly. So be sure to have a championship day with the Tampa St. Pete Sports Connection Saturdays from 12 to 2 on the Tan Talk family of stations.
Tampa Bay's Tan Talk, entertaining and informative radio for the Sunshine State.
There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever.
It's time for Be Local Buzz with Devin. Devin is the publisher and owner of Stroll Harbor Bluffs and Be Local Beaches magazines. She is also the founder of Raising Relief Foundation and the host of Be Local Buzz on the Tan Talk Radio Network. Now, here's Devin, your community connector.
Hey, hey, everyone. How are you? And welcome to Be Local Buzz with Devin every Thursday here from 4 to 5 on Tan Talk Radio. And I walked in and, oh, my God, I never get to see Ed. So I was so excited when I walked in and knowing that I was going to partner with Ed. Ed, they keep us apart for some reason. What's up?
It's not like I brought lunch or anything, you know?
That's all right. You're a cool guy. And where's Matt? Did he quit on me?
He's touring the country or doing something, I think. I don't know.
Wow. Well, I'm excited to work with you today.
Well, you got it.
Yeah. So did you find that song I wanted to open the show with?
I did, yeah.
Let's play a little bit.
You're going to play... What was that, Queen, I think it was.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll play that right now.
All right.
Yeah, absolutely. Here it comes. This is Queen.
All right. Do you know why I wanted to play that song today?
I give up.
All right. Well, today is June 8th, and it's Best Friend, National Best Friend Day.
I did not know that.
Oh, darn.
Right? So we all have besties out there. Yeah. We can't live life without our besties. So make sure you call your bestie and say, what? Happy National Best Friend Day.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Are you going to call your husband?
Well, he's one of my best friends.
Yeah, yes, and I know. I had like four besties that I had to send things out to, but that's good. When you're my age, you get a little bit more than one best friend.
Or you start getting less.
Or you start, you're right.
You get more selective.
You know what? Good point, because there was a time where I thought I had 30 best friends, right. And now I'm down to four. So maybe in a couple of years, I won't even have my husband anymore. Maybe I won't have, Ed, you'll have to be my best friend.
No problem.
Okay. All right. So what an incredible show we have today. I got two amazing women in here. I know I always have amazing women and guys, but these guys are like powerhouses. But Ed, I just want to talk about, and everyone out there, the Canadian fires, man. Oh, God. This year, they're saying that it is the worst and the most unhealthy it's been in like a couple decades. You could see it from New York. I have friends in New York. We were supposed to go to Harrisburg, Pennsylvania this weekend, and the fires, it's terrible. Harrisburg is almost getting evacuated.
Friends in Wilmington, Delaware are smoky.
Really?
Friends in Wilmington are smoky, yes. And Marty and I have actually been to British Columbia when the fires were going on. But this was 4 years ago, 5 years ago. It wasn't as bad as this year, and it was bad. So I can only imagine what it's like this year.
So I never actually knew that this is almost like it's a seasonal thing over there from May to October. So it's like our hurricane season and their fire season. Like I just didn't know that.
And believe it or not, it actually benefits the area. I know this, the hazard with the air quality, but you got to realize all that underbrush needs to be burned and new stuff grows back. And that's what animals thrive on. You know, they can't eat the old stuff. So all the underbrush gets burned out. And they hate to see it coming because, you know, it's a danger to the homes that are built and the air quality and stuff. but to the wildlife, it's actually a necessity.
I love you putting a positive spin on that. Thank you for doing that. That made me feel like better. And
actually, that's why you heard of control burns and stuff like that. That's how. Yeah. That's what they. That's why they do it, to keep the forest fires down.
Oh. Hmm. Well, they could have a little bit more control. It's unfortunate that it's just so. It is so bad right now, and I hope that it ends soon, and it just certainly doesn't go to October. Oh my God! All right. So we're going to start off the show. Who do I want to start it with? Who? All right. We're going to start it with Michelle. You're going to play a little song for her, and then we're going to have a little something to say about her before she speaks.
She can find your blood right by you if you just give her a try.
Wrong song. That's Natalie.
Move.
We could go into Natalie, though. We certainly can. We are flexible here.
One or the other.
Be Local Buzz with Devin is totally troubleshooters. Michelle. All right.
Sounded fun.
All right. All right. So best friend day. What are you going to do, Natalie? I got Natalie. I got Michelle. And what are you guys going to do out there for your best friend day? Hopefully you're stopping and getting flowers now, or sending out texts, emails, phone calls, something. But you definitely, although I didn't get any texts or phone calls. Wait a minute.
I got a best friend, and I don't even think she and I talk today. We talk every day. So
maybe she's telling you you're not the best friend.
No, I am the best friend, but I'll be giving her a call after the show. I didn't realize it was Best Friends Day.
Okay. All right, Ed, we can forget the song. Why don't we just go into what you're supposed to say before Michelle speaks? Because she's a VIP.
Securities offered through Cape Securities Incorporated, member FINRA and SIPC. This broadcast is not intended to recommend any specific investment. The information presented is derived from sources deemed to be reliable but cannot be guaranteed. Contact an investment, legal, or accounting professional before making any investment.
All right.
Really, that sounds really good, actually.
Yeah. Ed's, he's no amateur over there. He's been doing this. He's an expert for sure. So, Michelle Osborne, welcome to Be Local Buzz with Devin, Tan Talk Radio. It's amazing over here in Clearwater. We're on every 4 to 5.
Thank you.
Now, before I start, because I always forget to do this, if you had questions for any of our guests, you could always call 727-441-3000. So, Michelle, what's going on? Tell us a little bit what you do. What's Cape Securities?
Well, Cape Securities is my back firm in Atlanta, and they take care of all our operations. But it's so appropriate I'm here today with you and Natalie.
Yeah.
I actually specialize in something very different out there, which is deferring capital gains, which especially on real estate, businesses. Mm-hmm. Been doing this 4 decades. And
although she looks like she's 4 decades.
Aww, yeah. Thank you. I started when I was 12, right?
Yeah. It's just crazy when people start saying things like that. And I'm looking at her, I'm like, I don't know. Is she talking about herself? Yeah,
I hate to say how many years I've been in business.
Wow.
You know, I've worked with people that are mostly over the age of 55 and they're looking for that retirement. And I specialize in creating income, and I create income that is tax advantaged. It's a different type of planning. You're actually going into a different part of your life. Mm-hmm. You know, you're beginning to think, well, maybe I should slow down a little bit, or maybe I should start getting income from my investments. And you're hitting that 60-year-old period. And that's a magic number at 59 and a half. You can start taking that income, but it's how you take it. And then a lot of people that come to me, they're looking to sell portfolios of real estate. You know, they own 10, 15, 20 mm-hmm. homes, and they're looking and they're going, I've owned this for 20, 30 years. What am I going to do? Mm-hmm. It's going to be taxed probably at 30-35% total. So that's where I come in and I make it go away. We call it swap to drop. There's specific types of investments that we use and types of planning that you don't normally do in a normal planning situation.
So, Michelle, I told you, she's the expert again, 727-441-3000. Michelle, how did you get into this?
Oh, wow. I started many years ago at Merrill Lynch. I worked for 2 years as an apprentice.
They wouldn't let me be a broker. And
do I dare ask why?
No, don't ask.
Okay.
That was
we wouldn't like those answers.
But, you know, women just did not do what I do.
Right.
And so I went through 2 years of no pay and listened and watched and learned. And then I studied for 10 years at University of North Carolina and majored in economics. So it took a lot of learning from other people. And I've been privy to, you know, work with some of the best on the street. And I worked on Wall Street for a bit. I had a sprint there. So I was the only blonde female on the floor, which is a lot of fun.
Oh, I'm sure.
But I've been very privileged to work with a lot of firms and senior partnerships, which gives me a rounded, type of background, I should say.
So, yeah, you hear financial planning, right? But you do like a niche market, right? I mean, can you talk about what you do and, who benefits from your experience, your background? How do you help your clients?
Yes. I guess someone that is beginning to start looking at retirement.
Okay.
They are self-made. Type of person.
Like an entrepreneur?
Usually someone that comes to me, they'll have a real estate portfolio.
Mm-hmm.
They're looking to sell. They don't want to do the toilets, tenants, and trash anymore. It's just a little bit much. And so we're able to create something that will just give you a check every month like they're used to getting. So that's creating more income. Then we also look at the whole situation. What are you paying in the tax area? Where's your tax bracket, your business, are you beginning to sell out of your business? There's opportunities now that there didn't used to be that you can sell a business and defer the capital gains on that as well. Then we look at the wealth transfer. Do they have children? Do they have family? And most of the time lately, in the last few years, I've taken over portfolios that are the typical 60-40. And with the fees of 1.65%.
Okay, so what does 60-40 mean? For some of us are like, I don't know, 60-40, what does that mean? So you're not alone out there if you're listening to this, or if you're on Facebook Live, thank you. We'll wave to you.
And I apologize, I've got a little bit of a cold. 60% in equities and 40% in bond positions.
Okay.
That's what most planners are taught when they get in the business. This is the way you do a portfolio. And they also go into specific equities. Well, I learned when I was on Wall Street, the individual investor really doesn't stand a chance when it comes to picking stock. So having been in this business for decades and been a top producer at several firms, I know a lot of people that run these actual funds, or I know some of their companies and their firms. You need to take their lead. And what I use are something that's tried and true. I'm kind of old fashioned. I like to use things that's been around 40, 50 years. They have a history. They have a background. You know, they're a proven record. I know them. I know where they're based out of, and I know what they've done in these markets because they actually are in the know, and they know each other at the top. So a lot of times they will already be trading among themselves. So they're already ahead of everybody else.
Right.
So that's part of what we do. So we look at the portfolios. I took one over last year and the people owned Amazon 15 times in different accounts. if you own Amazon 15 times, you're taking a lot more risk in that specific situation. So it's not just the capital gains or the tax situation. It's also what are you investing your retirement in or your portfolio in? Using the same portfolio as an example, last year bonds started taking a dive because of rates. Well, common sense tells you if rates are going to go up, bonds are going to go down usually, typically. So I started selling off the positions in the bond portfolios as soon as we saw where the Fed was headed down the road. So this really helped that portfolio because it had been in the negative for quite some time. Plus, they were paying 1.65% in fees. And no offense to any RIA out there that charges fees. I just like to we like to earn our money.
Okay. So where do you see like the economy is like the hot topic right now? Where do you see the economy going in 12 months?
You know, in the last 2 years, we've seen a really hot real estate market. Yeah. I know Nellie's been very busy.
And we'll hear about that in a little bit, right?
You know, and people ask me, well, you know, is now the time to sell? Well, with rates going up as they have over the last year, and we think they're going to pause next week when the Fed meets again, you really need to think about this. So what's going to happen to the housing market, the individual housing market? The individual housing market is probably going to start sliding back. It has across the United States. Florida and Texas are kind of different. Florida and Texas are actually hot
on the rise
states.
Yeah. Thank you for Be Local, because that's why Be yeah. Local magazine is here, because everyone's moving here. Yeah.
And a lot of people are moving here and they're moving to Texas. Well, there's other reasons for that. You know, there's a lot of shelters in Florida and Texas that you can use mm-hmm. to protect your assets. You know, many famous people have moved here and put their assets under the state of Florida. Plus, there's no income tax. So there's right. a lot of financial benefits for moving here, along with the weather and everything else. But I'm seeing the economy slow down temporarily. Mm-hmm. And when I say temporarily, markets shift and they find their way. If we do have a recession, it'll probably be maybe 3-4 months. It's going to be short-lived because we're going into a political year.
Right. That's right.
Political year, they have to look good, right? So,
yeah. Yeah.
So things have to start moving along. People have to start feeling better about the economy. They want their, you know, their 401ks and their retirement accounts to start moving again, which, you know, we've kind of just been flat the last 6 months.
So
I really see the economy getting back up to about, on the Dow, 35,000-36,000.
Excellent. So if you're just getting in your car and you're tuning in, you're like, what's going on? Well, what's all this talk about money and finances and the economy and everything? We got Michelle Osborne over here from Cape Securities. And she is our guest today, and she is a financial guru. So please keep us on. And if you have any questions for her, you can call 727-441-4000. And again, it's Be Local Buzz with Devin, your community connector. So I have a question for you. What about, you just do Florida?
No, I'm licensed in about 15 states.
Whoa.
I have clients all over the United States now. It's because I work with two local intermediaries, 1031. We use 1031 exchange companies to help our clients defer capital gains. So, yeah, they're all over the country, and I've been flying to see a lot of them lately, Nevada, California, Texas, a lot of good people.
And I just want to say something, knowing you personally, and which I'm like so honored to. Thank you, Tom, for introducing us, which we'll talk about Burn Fitness and Impulse a little later. Okay. What do you think?
Awesome.
But I just want to say what I do know about you is you are certainly a workaholic. And I mean that in the best way, because your passion for it, I don't even want to use the word clients, because it's like your family, you know, your passion for the people that you help yeah. is just unbelievable. And
thank
I just
you.
See that. And it's just like, and she says, right, I fly there to meet them. She's not just doing Zoom calls. She is actually flying across the United States to actually meet them and sit down with them and really show how much you care. And because you do care.
I do.
So
you know,
that's.
My clients do become my very good friends, speaking of best friend day. You know, we all are kind of in the same boat. We work too hard mm-hmm. for what we have, you know. So you have to take that into consideration when you're working with a client. And this is their next step, their next chapter.
Yeah.
I've actually become a psychologist sometimes because they don't know what to do with themselves once all this income starts coming in, and now they don't have the business anymore, and they sold off the real estate portfolio, and they're like, well, what do I do with myself now?
Well, I'm taking volunteers for Raising Relief Foundation, the nonprofit. But seriously, but you're saying, like, right, they're going into a different phase of their life, so retirement. It's a very scary, I mean, it can be very exciting, but it is a very scary part of the next chapter in your life, because it's kind of like, your final chapter of your life, right? I mean, yeah. It is what it is.
And
so,
Working with some of the higher net worth individuals and seeing what they've done with their portfolios, real estate portfolios, for example, let's say you've made all your money on just flipping houses all your life. You know, that's something that you're used to, you know that. And so taking them into another position, it can be scary. So you have to teach them over and over again, and selling their business. God, that's their baby. You know,
right.
I work with people with very large real estate across the United States, and they're beginning to sell out. And this is all they've ever done.
Right.
So when that's your baby, it's hard to let go.
Of course.
But you know, at some point you're going to have to. And do you do it when you're younger, 60, 65, or do you wait until you almost have to leave it to an estate planning attorney to take care of it? So the best time is get out while the getting's good, generally. Mm-hmm. So we help a client not only transition into that part of their life, but to also, what are you going to do with all this income now? You know, what are you going to do with your life?
That's a problem I need to have. I really do. I think, Ed, I need that problem. Can you call my husband and tell him to call Michelle? Because I need that problem.
Yeah. People, we can create all the income in the world, but if you turn around paying it to Uncle Sam for tax, it doesn't do any good. Yeah. So I try to also work the other side and make sure that most of what we've earned over the years or what we're earning now isn't just paid out in tax, which we finish with the client all the way through their life. So if they have children, we make sure the wealth transfer is taken care of to the children. I'm working with an estate right now. You know, the estate's already built. It's already done. And it's a lot of money. But these people don't need any more money. They just need to make sure that what they worked for doesn't go to waste.
Right.
And they want to make sure that the grandchildren, not their children, but the grandchildren, don't lose it.
Right.
And so you never know who's involved after someone goes. And so I try to cover all bases with a client and go, well, you never know who that granddaughter may date.
Right.
You know, so you got to make sure that all areas and all aspects. So I guess that's where 4 decades come in.
Oh, my God. Well, I'm going to ask you one more question, then we'll get back to you.
Sure.
But let's talk a little bit about the company, because I'm sure you could work anywhere. So why? Why Cape Securities? Like, what do they have that you, what's their vision, their mission that you really like and you've been attracted to and you decided to jump on board with them?
We're a small firm out of Atlanta, about 200 brokers, and I'm one of the seniors there. One of the things that I love about this, I love my compliance officer. We're about the same age and know each other really well. The person that does my due diligence, who helps me pick who we're going to do business with, a great guy. You know, the owners of the firm have been around just like, so we're kind of in an area that we all have a lot of experience. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of my contingency plan too. They take over my book if anything happens to me. So that's one of the reasons I like to use them. Also, Cape and other firms like us in the smaller BD arena, we can pick and choose what we offer. And so a lot of firms can't offer DSTs, which is what I'm talking about, deferring capital gains, or they can't offer an alternative investment. And an alternative investment is just a whole different vehicle in itself, but it's part of a client's portfolio when they get to that certain point in their life, and should be. The way I manage money is I have a great mix of, you know, a third equity portfolios, a third in fixed type of portfolios, and then a third in a different kind of real estate, very large real
estate. So you have like little, you have niches that a lot of other companies don't have, it sounds like.
Exactly.
Excellent. So how does someone get in contact with you?
They can call me at 727-459-4875.
And you can find her in your Stroll Harbor Bluffs magazine, and there's going to be a big article spread for her, about her.
Yeah, it's, you know, and thank you, Devin, for pushing me to get back into media. You know, I used to do a radio show. I have one from Wall Street to Main Street, and I had a television show in News
Call. Oh, geez.
So
how cool is that? From Wall Street to Main Street. I love it.
I like that.
It's fun to be back here. Thank you so much for
having me. Excellent. Yeah. Well, we're going to hold that thought. We're going to get back to you. I just had this girl over here. here is another rock star. And when you're talking about real estate, it makes me think of, let's go to Natalie. So I have Natalie Scott with us. Ed, do we have a song for her? Yeah, this one.
If you just give her a try, let's start this listing up right.
Players.
Radio, presence, family, come on.
Who?
Girl,
where y'all trying to move?
Real estate agent magic in your area.
Look out!
Pop, pop, it's showtime.
Showtime.
Showtime. Gonna sell your house again. Oh, they don't know.
Showtime.
Oh, they don't know.
Showtime.
They want to buy as soon as they walk in.
Showtime.
And if you might think you're ready to buy, don't give yourself the blues. Don't look too hard, might hurt yourself.
Leave the working too crispy loose.
Woo! Sell it. She's a dangerous girl with some keys in her pocket.
Okay, I have this.
All right, Ed, we'll let her.
What
the heck did you get that?
I love it. I actually called that band and said, please make a song for Natalie Scott for Be Local Buzz with Devin.
Yeah.
So they came together with the Real Estate Agent Magic song.
Love it.
Yes, love it.
Well, that's what we do sometimes is magic. But,
all right. Okay, so here we are. We got Natalie Scott with us. Yay! Natalie. You're listening to Michelle. What do you think?
My head is spinning. I have so many questions for you. I have so many clients that would love to talk to you.
Great.
I get a lot of my clientele are coming from outside of the state, as we know. And they're coming from states that they never came to the West Coast before. But I actually get clients that are coming here for tax reasons.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And whether they're getting ready to sell a very large business and they'd rather be a Florida resident when they sell. Mm-hmm. I never really thought about that, but it's a big, and you could explain that. They come here for the retirement years for the same reason, tax benefits. And of course, it's our lifestyle, which is beautiful. It's a year-round outdoor lifestyle. So, you know, to sell Tampa Bay is not a hard sell.
Right.
And especially once they've determined they don't want to be on the East Coast or they don't want to be further south than us or further north than us, Tampa Bay is the perfect place for most of my buyers.
Yeah.
But no, I'm calling you.
I knew this would be a good chemistry collaboration.
Even because I own real estate. And at what point, you know, what do we do with it?
So. Yeah. And we and the thing is now we got to use it while we got it.
Yeah.
You know, because we never know when the 1031s or the deferrals or any of these opportunities will go away.
Gosh.
We don't know who's going to be elected next. So,
right.
You know, and I just tell my clients, now's the time.
Okay. Well, then I've got lots of people to talk to. My one question for you is, do you have in-house legal, like estate planners?
I have
trusts.
I have legal plan. I have attorneys that I refer to. Yes.
Okay. That's
locally,
a big question.
Locally. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And nationally.
So Natalie, welcome.
Thanks.
Thanks for coming on, Michelle, of course. And
it's a great connection.
So if you have any questions, it's 727-441-3000. And we are talking to Natalie Scott. So Natalie, who do you work for and what exactly do you do? Because she's another one that you're going to be like, oh, I have people to refer to you too. Yeah. So
she's
go ahead.
Connector there.
Yeah, she is a connector.
Is
so I'm with Compass Real Estate and started my career in real estate in South Tampa. And then about 8 years ago, my husband, Marty Kehoe, lured me to the beach. And so we're now Indian Rocks Beach residents. We live on the water. We're big boaters, as everybody knows. We love it. And I take all my clients out on the boat and, you know, show them what this lifestyle is about. And they fall in love with it.
Mm.
And many times they realize they want a boat too. But if they don't want a boat, we have lots of wonderful boat clubs. So newest project I did, which I'd like to brag about, is I have a listing that just came live at 1579 Alexander Road in Bel Air. Bel Air, as you know, is a beautiful, beautiful community, family-oriented estates. It reminds me of the Northeast in many ways with the tree-lined streets.
Tight-knit. Everyone cares about it. It's a true sense of community.
Yes.
But, you know, I kind of feel that way about Pinellas County, but right?
Bel Air, yeah, Bel Air is very special.
I totally agree.
It kind of reminds me of South Tampa in a way, because I lived in Hyde Park in Davis Islands. So one of the new divisions that my husband, Marty Kehoe of WKM Restoration Group, because of my business in real estate, I sell a lot of large properties on the water. And many of these properties are failing because of water intrusion. Mm-hmm. So Marty was always in commercial real estate for over 40 years. And he saw the need for these large residential properties that really need a commercial restoration. So his business has just taken off. It's called WKM Coastal Home Solutions. So he had a property in Bel Air that was being renovated. And they said, we've got to talk to my wife. Sure enough, I came in. I'm also an interior designer. So this house was gutted to the studs, and it had a complete commercial restoration inside and out. And I was fortunate enough to get involved early on. So I helped with all of the interior finishes, paint colors, tiles, you know, you name it, countertops. It's now on the market. It's getting a lot of attention because there's nothing else quite like it. It's like a new construction.
Is that the one I saw?
Yeah, that you came by.
Oh, it's beautiful.
It's staged now. You've got to see it now. It's finished.
So Natalie, again, listen to it. Tell our viewers and our listeners right now, where is that property again?
It's 1579 Alexander Road, Bel Air, Florida. And it's literally two doors from the entry of the Bel Air Country Club. And because of its location, it's part of the country club community, that if you purchase this home, you get to get in front of the line for your membership at Bel Air with the golf. Golf membership is 6 years right now. So if you purchase this home, you get your membership and you get a 25% discount. So there's a lot of reasons that this home works for a lot of people. Plus it's 0.44 acre. It's wooded lot, quiet trees.
It's breathtaking.
Lap swimming pool. You know, it's spectacular. So call me about that. I'd love to show you. So that's kind of a new part that I've opened up in my business, is I see the need for properties to be put in a condition for the highest sale price. And again, I think I said this last time I was on, I see people leaving so much money on the table. And I'm getting some other new listings coming up where I say, look, a little bit of paint, a little bit of staging, a little bit of landscaping. You can sell it for 1-1, or you can sell it for 1-3 or 4.
Right.
So it really makes a big, big difference. And I've got some case studies on that. So with my design background and with my contacts in the trades, you know, I've got everybody that can do everything as far as construction and renovation. I think we're a really exciting team.
So, yeah. So, again, this is Be Local Buzz with Devin, your community connector. And one thing that I pride myself on and is our network. Because we handpick the best of the best, the people that really have the niches in the market. Just like, you know, Michelle, you're definitely the, I mean, amazing. And Natalie, the same thing. So you have, so we have a real estate person here who is not just a real estate person. She has a design background. She has a husband that I call is like the forensic construction, right? Because they don't they don't just like, you know, put up the walls. They go in and see what is really happening to the bones. Are they breaking? Are they going, you know? It's so it's like a person. You treat it like a person over there. So talk a little bit about that, because if you seriously, if you're going to want to hire the best, or you want to get involved with the best, this is the show. And you can always find them on our website, strollharborbluffs.com. So talk about how important that is, especially living on the water.
You know, the things that I see when they start taking an exterior wall off of a home, and what we see inside is literally frightening. You can have a minute hole in your windowsill, below your window, anywhere on your exterior. And you start within a year or two, you're noticing some leakage and you think, oh, I just need to paint the house. You really need somebody like Marty's firm to go in and do an investigation, because he's doing a project right now in Reddington Beach. Beautiful home. A lot of these properties are new. They're only constructed. One of them was only a year old and needed 750,000 renovation. Some are just 6 or 7 years old. But if they're not installed properly when you do construction, you get a little drip of water that turns into year after year. You open up the side of the house, the studs are rotten, the insulation's gone, the dry rot and everything that's in there that nobody sees from the inside.
Right.
And so the house really needs to be properly waterproofed, closed back up, and now you've got the guarantee and peace of mind that it was done by a commercial construction company right. that specializes in water intrusion and waterproofing. So I see it all the time in my business. And like with some of my clients that I take out, I'll have Marty come look and he'll say, Nat, we really need to open this up. So part of my contract is during the home inspection period, I get approval to make some holes in the house, outside or inside. If we choose, the contract falls through, the seller has to put it back in its condition. So it's no skin off anybody's back to let us do this, but it helps my clients see what they're getting into.
Mm. Wow.
Yeah, because that could be an open can of worms.
Yeah.
And it has been several times, I'm sure,
with
you.
Many, many times.
But you know what? It's doing the right thing.
It
right?
Is.
It's doing the right thing. And how many people would be like, oh my God, rotten. Okay, just put up a piece of drywall and paint it. No one will ever know.
Yep. Yep. Meanwhile, it's rotting on the rest of the house, you know. So.
Well, then you've got mold issues, right?
Right.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
So that's a dangerous situation. Mm-hmm. I have a question for you. You probably have a lot of people that have investment properties.
I have a lot.
How many people are still holding on to that because they don't want to pay the capital gains on it?
Quite a few.
Yeah.
Quite a few.
It's a rampant issue right now.
I hear it all the time.
Yeah. And with this administration right now, you know, like I said, we don't know when we're going to get the next move. So it's our time to help.
So
them,
I'll
right?
reach out to all of my investor clients that have, I mean, they've purchased numerous properties from me. Some they sell and do a 1031 and buy something else. Mm-hmm. But I think a lot of them have handfuls of these and they're all retirement years.
Yeah.
Some of my clients are early 70s going, I can't take it with me. I got to do something.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And are you finding that they're at that point in their life? They just don't want to do it anymore. They don't want to deal with, you know, their portfolios or even the big house. I'm finding clients that are selling their, you know, bigger houses because, you know, they're scaling as they get older.
Yeah.
You know, and they're beginning to scale down.
Yeah.
But it can be an issue.
Oh, no. Well, definitely good symbiotic.
Yeah, it is. I know. I love it. I knew it was going to be, and I love it so much because our listeners are like, oh, this is cool. You know, we got the real estate, we got the financial. So I'm going to ask you the same question. Where do you see the economy in the next 12?
Yeah. Doing a little like noodling on it before I came in today.
Noodling. Do you put like spaghetti?
No,
do you eat pasta?
What's noodling? You know, noodling around.
That's cute. But, I like that. You're so cute.
Yeah. So I was talking. I don't see Tampa Bay slowing down.
No.
I see that we are in a space right now that I'm actually encouraging people to buy because interest rates did go up. It scared a lot of people. People that have to move are still moving and getting their loans, and they're dealing with the new interest rate. But we're entering a time, unless it's the perfect property, the perfect price, we're not getting huge bidding wars, and we're definitely not selling over asking like we were in 2020 and 2021. I am getting multiple bids still, but I'd say the majority of our properties are selling back to normal, like a few percentage points under asking. As soon as that interest rate starts to go down, everybody's going to be coming back out, and you're going to miss this wave of being able to maybe get some deals, maybe. And it really depends on where it is, you know.
And who it is.
And like South Tampa, people are moving there to raise their families. They're working. Clearwater Beach, they're coming for a second home. So those buyers might be, I'll just wait a little bit and see what happens. But, you know, the people that have to move and want to come, they're jumping in. But I would say now's the time to buy.
And why you, Natalie? What makes you? What makes you? I know why. I know why, but I want you.
Well, I mean, I think I've said a few of those things. My experience as an interior designer for a million years. I've bought and sold God knows how many properties for myself. I've bought and sold investment properties, numerous homes. I've really never lost anything in real estate. I think I'm with the number one brokerage in the country, Compass. We have amazing technology, amazing reach. The relocation that we do with the Compass agents around the country is, it's mind-boggling how many referrals I get from Compass agents all over the country. Because they're top producers, they know they can call a Compass agent. And Clearwater, I just got one 2 days ago. It's over $1 million listing. And, you know, obviously I'm a hard worker. I take real estate as my career, not my hobby. Every business I've had has been, you know, a career, not a hobby. But I do also still make it fun. Mm-hmm. And I think it's personal. I mean, to find a home for somebody, what could be more personal?
Right.
So I really want to make sure it's the right fit. You know, yeah. If it's not the right fit, I'll let the client know. You know, like we'll talk about what is it? What's your lifestyle? What do you want? Like, are we really buying this at the right price? And if we do buy it at this price, what is it going to cost to update it? Well, I can do that.
Right.
Because I've been in interior design. I've been in construction. So when a client sees a house, they go, oh, boy, I can never do this. Oh, my God. I'll say, guys, it's really not that much. It's like X for some floor, X for some walls. Why don't you be the one to make money on the property instead of that investor that comes in and puts in builder grade cheap stuff? You know,
right.
And people are buying that stuff because they think it looks done.
Yeah.
But is it really done correctly?
That is what sets you apart. You definitely have, of course, the experience. You have the passion, the heart, and you said it. This is a career. This is your mission. This is your purpose. This is your why, right?
Yes.
Funny story. I remember when I first moved here. Well, first of all, when we were trying to move here, we could not get a real estate person to call us back. I mean, it was
That's crazy.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure it still happens. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And then when I finally did move here, I went to my first networking thing. It was over in Largo. And I swear to God, there was 9 out of 10 people who were real estate people. And I'm like, I wonder how many people are really real estate people, right? Yeah, right. A lot of people get cards and it's not. So a lot of people do it as a hobby, not just real estate. A lot of jobs I've seen, right? Even in my business, it's like a hobby for them, but it's not really their mission, their why, their heart, their purpose. And same thing I said about Michelle. You take them out boating. They become your family. You want to make sure that you're getting them the best.
Yeah, and they become right friends. So you want to do right by a friend.
Of course.
Exactly.
You know?
Of course. How does someone get in contact with you?
They can call me at 813-310-8982. Or you can just Google me, Natalie Scott Real Estate, and I pop up on the Google page.
You can Google her and noodle her.
You can Google me. That's the easiest way to find anybody,
right.
Google.
And then you can find her on Stroll Harbor Bluffs also.
Right.
So I just want to go around to our guests one more time before we get into what's happening in entertainment this week. Mm-hmm. So Michelle, again, tell us, who you are, where do you work, and what's your 30-second commercial?
Well, first of all, I want to say thank you. This is just great synergy today.
Yeah, awesome.
Natalie and I just, you know, I can tell by listening to her, talking to her, she has the same kind of passion for her clients. And, you know, you're not going to do anything for them you wouldn't do for yourself.
Right.
I like that. Yes.
That's a big philosophy. I can tell that right off the bat. And it takes, you know, I'm a financial planner and advisor, but there's so many different types of planners and advisors out there. I like to think that I have a very well-rounded background in that I look at every single room in the house, in your financial house.
Right.
You know, in every aspect so that, you know, maybe the attorney missed something. You need to call the attorney and get them to fix it. Or maybe your accountant missed something. And it can mean a lot of money to our clients. So it's kind of a different take on retiring at 55, whether you have a huge real estate portfolio, a business, or you're looking to start getting into the next chapter.
Excellent. And Michelle, again, who do you work with and how can someone find you?
My firm is Cape Securities and they can call me at 727-459-4875 or you can email me at Michelle at capesecurities.com.
And that's C-A-P-E, right?
Correct.
Excellent. And Natalie, what do you have to say about Michelle?
Well, I think, you know, we said it earlier on in the show. Michelle is exactly the type of person that I would refer my clients to. And I'm very interested in what this 1031 exchange situation is that you're talking about, because I've not heard of it, and I'm a bit shocked that it exists. So I will, and I think I might want to refer myself to you.
Yeah.
So, yeah, because Marty and I are, you know, not retiring anytime soon. I don't think I'll ever retire.
I don't think so.
I love what I do.
Yeah.
I mean, I think I'd get bored, but I would like to make sure I have enough money.
Right. But it's not like a job. When you're doing something truly passionate about and it's your mission, it's not like your job.
Yeah.
Right.
But you have to be careful if something happens in your life that you can't work. You want to know that you're financially.
Well, God, of course. Of course.
Taken care of.
You know, and a lot of people are sitting out a real estate market just for a few years, you know, waiting on it to kind of check out, you know, in other areas of the country. So this is a way for them to park. Also, you can kind of go in and out.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
So tell everyone again where they can find you, what you do, and, you know, you buy, sell, everything, right?
Yep. I'm Natalie Scott with Compass Real Estate. I'm a real estate advisor. I work a lot with people relocating to Tampa Bay. I'm from Tampa, raised my children in South Tampa. In the past 8 years, I've lived in Indian Rocks Beach, but the entire time I lived in Tampa, we had a condo in Clearwater. So I'd like to say I'm well-versed in all of Tampa Bay. I've done some business in Tarpon Springs, Newport Richey. Those are really kind of exciting emerging markets. Mm-hmm. Newport Richey actually has a cute little downtown now. Another big market is Zephyr Hills. That little downtown's rebranding themselves. So, so I'm here for all of your real estate needs.
Excellent. And how can someone find you?
They can call me at 813-310-8982.
And then I always like to end our show with the cool things that are happening. First, I'd like to say thank you, ladies, so much for being a guest on Be Local Buzz with Devin. Thank you, Edge.
Yep.
But let's see what we have going on today. Oh, we have A&G Dance Academy. The 11th annual celebration is going to be June 10th, which is what? What's today? Thursday. So that would be Saturday. At 4 o'clock at the Mahaffey Theater. I love that there. And then Donna the Buffalo. Oh, I don't know what that's all about, but they're at Janus Landing. So if they're Janus Live down there, that means they're kind of some kind of like funky crazy hip hop.
I haven't been there yet. I guess I'm moved beyond.
I'll be there because I love that kind of stuff.
I need
Donna,
to start going.
Donna the Buffalo. Wow. Ed, do you know them?
Well outnumbered.
No, I don't, but Janus Landing's pretty cool. A nice little concert area.
Oh, yeah. I love it. Exactly. And then they have another event on June 11th, and House of Cheer is at Ruth Eckerd Hall on June 11th. Summer Camp, Princesses and Dragons. How cute is that? That is going to be the 12th through the 16th at the Murray Theater, and it's ages 5 to 10, and it's 9 to 3 for the kids. That's actually good. I'm glad Mark put this in here about the summer camps for kids. It's important. Summer Camp and School of Rock Musical at the Murray Theater. That is going to be August 3rd, and that is ages 14 to 18. So if you want to know some cool things to do with your kids, go to your Stroll Harbor Bluffs June edition, and we're telling you that. All right, so Ed, I just want to say, have a great weekend. Ladies, have a great weekend. Listeners, viewers, thank you so much for tuning in to Be Local Buzz, your community connector, every Thursday from 4 to 5 on Tan Talk Radio. Have a fabulous, fabulous weekend. Thank you.
Thank you, Devin.
Just call me, 'cause when I'm there.